This is the tragic story of the fastest marathon runner to ever live. He burst onto the marathon running scene and in less than a year would go from an unknown talent to reaching the pinnacle of the sport and dethroning the reign of the greatest marathoner of all time, Eliud Kipchoge. This is the story of Kenyan runner Kelvin Kiptum.
It's going to be a massive course record. A year ago, you wouldn't have known much about him. The fastest ever debutant, the fastest ever second half of a race.
What could he have done better? He won one by almost 3 minutes, another one by more than 3 minutes.
Up to 28.05, 10K, from 30K to 40K. It's one of the most insane closes I've ever seen.
2 hours and 35 seconds.
What could a marathoner do that's better?
Kiptum's early life is not well documented, and his career history before 2023 is actually quite unremarkable. He was born in December 1999 in the Kenyan village of Chepkorio, situated 2,600 meters above sea level, making it conducive to building strength for running. Kiptum would live humbly, often herding animals for his family, and began running at 13 in the dirt roads of his village. Like many young kids from Kenya, his real dream was to become an elite runner, and he started training towards that goal. At 18, he would win the Eldoret Half Marathon in Kenya and would go on to have a solid half marathon and 10k career for the next few years. He would hover around the 1 hour mark in the half marathon, getting around sub 59 in one race and placing respectably in most of his races, but he was never a serious contender for any elite level competition. But this was about to change. In 2023, Kiptum would make himself known in his marathon debut in Valencia, where he pulled an upset on race favourite Tamrit Tola, who is the current Paris 2024 Olympic marathon champion, to win in the fastest debut marathon time in history. Kiptum ran an astounding 2 hours, 1 minute and 53 seconds, which apart from being the fastest marathon debut, was also the 4th fastest time in history, only behind Eliud Kipchoge's 2 world records and Kenenisa Bekele's personal best in the marathon. And this sent the running world into shock. His performance was made more insane by the fact that he ran the second half of the race faster than the first half, suggesting that he had more in the tank and could have gone even quicker. Furthermore, the man was only 23 years old, when marathon runners typically peak around their late 20s to early 30s. So it seemed clear to everyone that Kiptum could run much faster over the next few years.
Look out for this name. It is here to last a few years. Kelvin Kiptum.
But to fully understand how good Kelvin Kiptum was, we need a reference point to compare to. And there is no better man than one Eliud Kipchoge. Kipchoge is a Kenyan marathon runner who is largely agreed to be the greatest of all time in the distance. He won 11 of his 12 first marathons, is a 2-time Olympic gold medalist in the marathon, and is a 2-time world record holder in the discipline. The Kenyan was also the first man to run the hallowed sub 2-hour marathon time in the Ineos 159 challenge in 2019, a feat which catapulted him to main stage fame. The 2-hour barrier is something that remains elusive to elite runners. It's the new 4-minute mile, the sub 10-second 100 meter. Breaking this barrier could be seen as the most impressive feat in all of distance running. The attempt had been made before in 2017 with the Nike Breaking 2 project, where Nike picked 3 of its sponsored athletes to try and break the time under assisted conditions. The project would ultimately fail, with Kipchoge achieving the fastest time of the 3 athletes, running 2 hours and 25 seconds. Close, but still a little way off. In 2019, his later attempt in the Ineos 159 challenge would prove successful, with Kipchoge running 1 hour, 59 minutes and 40 seconds. And this was a victory for everyone in distance running. Olympic gold medalists, world champions, and some of the fastest men in their respective distances formed a 40-man team to help Kipchoge keep a metronomic pace and act as a shield to allow him to draft behind. Although this was under assisted conditions and thus could not be counted as a world record, it showed the running world that this time was within reach, and it was a win for everyone. And our story transports us back to 2023 when Kipchoge was in his prime. He had come off a dominant performance in the Tokyo Marathon last year where he smashed the course record, running 2 hours, 2 minutes and 40 seconds. He would later beat his own world record in Berlin by 30 seconds, running 2 hours, 1 minute and 9 seconds, after running the first half of the marathon in under 2 hours. By this point, Kipchoge had been seen as untouchable by the running world. No one was even close to his level. For the first time, Kipchoge had found someone who threatened his dominance in the form of Kelvin Kiptum, something that people at the time thought may not happen for years. Kiptum would further threaten Eliud's reign in April 2023, where he would run the fastest time in the London Marathon and obliterate Kipchoge's course record of 2 hours, 2 minutes and 37 seconds, by running within just 16 seconds of the world record with a time of 2 hours, 1 minute and 25 seconds. This would be the second fastest marathon of all time, and given his destruction of Kipchoge's course record and the high profile of the London Marathon, this saw Kiptum's fame rise substantially. It proved to everyone that Valencia was not just a fluke. This man was the real deal and was within spitting distance of the world record, especially as this race was once again run with aggressive negative splits. What's more, the weather conditions during the London Marathon that year were less than ideal. The race was rainy that year, and whilst it's considered a fast marathon, London is not regarded as being as flat and quick as some of the other courses out there. This left many to wonder what would happen if Kiptum took on a course like Berlin, known for its world record breaking history. It seems that Kipchoge's spot as the fastest marathon runner ever was on borrowed time. Fans would not need to wait until Berlin to see a world record, however, as Kiptum would run in the Chicago Marathon later that year and run a staggering time of 2 hours and 35 seconds, which would shatter Kipchoge's previous world record by over 30 seconds. Within a year, Kiptum had gone from being an unknown runner trying to prove himself on the world stage to being the most talked about man in the entire sport. He had partnered with major sponsors such as Nike and was positioning himself as the face of other brands. Kiptum was undoubtedly the real deal, and now that he achieved the world record, there was one great barrier that lay before him, one that would immortalize this man in running history forever. Within 2 weeks of breaking the world record, Kelvin Kiptum announced his intention to break the 2-hour barrier in the Rotterdam Marathon in April 2024, and the hype train for that race began to build. For my money, I was expecting him to beat it. His aggressive negative splits in all his races showed that he always had some gas in the tank left. And if the race was paced correctly, there's no reason he could not break that elusive 2-hour mark. The hype would build as the race got closer. Whilst Kipchoge had broken the 2-hour barrier, the assisted conditions had prevented it from really counting as a world record. Although the Ineos 159 challenge had been a huge achievement, the time had not been officially broken just yet. In just a few months in April 2024, we would see possibly the final great barrier in men's distance running fall. Until...
On Sunday, just a few days ago, we learned of the devastating loss of Kelvin Kiptum.
World record-holding marathon runner Kelvin Kiptum has died.
On Sunday, Kenyan police said Kiptum lost control of his vehicle, veered off the road into a ditch, and hit a tree.
He died along. Kelvin Kiptum would be involved in a car accident that killed both him and his coach in February. It was reported that he lost control of his car while driving at night, and that would put a shock end to Kelvin's life. Athletes both retired and active would pay tribute to his life and offer their condolences. Eliud Kipchoge said he was deeply saddened and had a whole life ahead of him to achieve greatness. Mo Farah said that Kiptum was a special talent and would have gone on to have an amazing career. And so, Kiptum's career would end even more suddenly than it started after tragedy struck. He would have a state funeral in Kenya and leave athletics fans around the world wondering what could have been. Kipchoge would suffer from a huge amount of online abuse by conspiracists who claim he had somehow orchestrated the car crash, despite there being no evidence to support this. To this day, Kiptum's world record still stands, and is yet to be even approached by anyone in the marathon running world. Although it has only been a year since the record was broken, it seems unlikely that any active athlete right now will even come close to Kiptum's time, allowing his short but powerful legacy to be remembered. I do want to add that there are some question marks over aspects of his career, such as his age and the doping allegations that will inevitably follow any athlete at the elite level. This is something I'm interested in making a video on, but I want to be careful about not disrespecting a dead man's legacy and falling into conjecture without much to go on. Let me know if this is something you want to see a video about. If you want to see a breakdown on Kipchoge's career and his eventual decline, then click on this video here. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Happy training.